So we place it in front of the noun. If I say this is a grave situation, it's serious. Does grave have another meaning, or does it have another form? Do you know the noun form for grave?
Yeah.
It's a completely different meaning.
Yeah.
It means something different, though. And we're not using it in that situation or in that context. So we don't have verb, and we do not have, well, actually, we do have an adverb.
We have verb. Mm-hmm.
You have a verb?
Yes.
Grave.
For grave?
Gravely.
No, same thing. Gravely.
She smiled gravely.
Oh, okay.
Can you smile in a serious way? Can you nod in a serious way? She spoke gravely.
Slowly?
Seriously. Like in a very calm, very formal, very serious manner. Okay? So maybe we put an X through that, because the noun form of grave is where you bury someone when they die. That is serious, but it's a different meaning. So serious, when you see grave used in front of a noun, as an adjective, we know that we're talking about something that is not funny, it's not light, it's serious. Main idea?
I
heard the most important idea. Or topic of an article or essay. Bless you.
Bless you.
Okay, we don't have a verb form, adjective, or adverb. Paraphrase.
Is that false?
Paraphrase is a noun, but it can also be used as a verb.
Same word. Right?
Same spelling, same pronunciation. It's simply how we use it in the sentence. You will write 4 paraphrases. Please paraphrase
the
4 sentences. So 2 different ways to place it in the sentence: as an action, as your verb, or as your noun, as your object. You will write a paraphrase. So definition for paraphrase?
Combine.
Restatement. Other authors.
Explain.
Idea. You could say explanation. That
or
would work as well. Explanation of an author's idea, restatement of an author's idea. Somewhere in your definition, you want to show that you understand that you're telling someone else's idea. Talking about it for academic English, so I'll say the goal or reason
an author
writes. And we've talked about verbs that we use to indicate purpose. Inform, entertain,
perform,
argue,
information,
to give information, explain,
Paraphrase to.
Paraphrase, sure, to restate, to paraphrase, to teach. Quotation.
I put when you party something from.
It's like
something someone say that. No, it's not.
Text that is copy. When we talk about it as a noun, we can use the verb form, we can say quote. Good. Quote. Please quote the author. This quotation is important because we sometimes will hear quoted used as an adjective. Please do not use quoted material. Do not use quoted text. If your teacher tells you do not use quoted text, then your teacher wants you to paraphrase.
Mm-hmm.
Write it in your own words. We don't have an adverb. Synonym.
Same word, but different words.
Same meaning.
Same meaning, different words.
Different way.
Same meaning, different word.
Different word, same meaning. Now, we do not have a verb for synonym. We do.
Synonymly.
Synonymly, synonymous. That's really another noun form though, so really we'll focus on the noun form. So synonym, quotation, echo me please, synonym, synonym, synonym,
synonym,
quotation,
quotation,
quote,
quote,
quoted,
quoted,
purpose,
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 purpose.
Paraphrase.
Paraphrase.
Main idea.
Main idea.
Grave.
Grave.
Deprivation.
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 Deprive.
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 Clause.
Clause.
Brackets.
Brackets.
Okay. Notice with what happens with deprivation to deprive. We could tap out, and let's count the number of syllables in the stress pattern. If we fold and clap for deprivation, deprivation, deprivation.
Four, five.
Deprivation is a 4-3.
Good.
So four syllables, third one is strongest. What about deprive? Deprive. Cross, clap, tap. Deprive.
Two, one,
syllables.
Deprive. How many syllables?
Two.
Which one is strongest?
One, two.
The first one.
Deprive.
No,
the second
one.
Two, one.
Deprive. Or deprive.
Two, one.
Is it deprive or
two, two.
Deprive?
Two, two.
Deprive.
Two, two. Okay.
Oh.
Good. Deprive.
Two, two, eight.
That's something when you take the 6C communication class, you take a look at words. And how when you look at the same word but a different form, sometimes the stress shifts. It can either move forward in the word from the third syllable to the two. Well, this is only two syllables for the verb form. Or sometimes it stays the same. Okay. Down at the bottom of your page, you have a sentence that I've taken from our book. In spite, this is a quotation, in spite of the importance of sleep, many people are not getting enough. This is from Glass. So, in spite of the importance of sleep, many people are not getting enough. How could we restate this? How could we put this into our own words? Before we do this, though, I want to show you something. Yeah, let me turn this off. what you just saw. Tell the person next to you what you just saw. I'm going to listen.
I still have one.
Don't judge it. Just say what you saw. Okay?
I saw a drinking water from the toilet.
I said, I saw
what you
said. Mom.
Subject. What was the
reason? I know what was happening. I opened the bedroom.
The woman is doing something bad.
We
didn't even see the woman until now.
Because
she kissed the dog. Well, you're judging. So, but I didn't ask you to judge. I asked you to tell me what you saw. So what did you see?
I see the dog.
Drinking water from
because the family didn't learn the dog teach.
They didn't teach the dog. They didn't close the toilet. Okay. Okay. So we saw a dog drinking from an unclean place, and then the lady came home and let the dog lick her mouth. Okay. So you just paraphrased. You just stated what you saw. I chose it because it was short and silly. And if you have animals, then you know sometimes our dogs don't do this. I don't know why. They don't go in our bathrooms either. So I think they're afraid of the bathrooms at our house.
That's good.
That's good. So, but they make messes in other areas. So the same idea, think about when you watch movies or if you watch television shows, don't you tell your friends about what you see?
Yes, we do.
You're paraphrasing all the time. So it's the same idea. You don't tell them everything.
Mm-hmm.
Like
like quotation.
Like this happened, and then this happened. If you watch a movie that's 2 hours long, does it take 2 hours for you to tell your friend everything?
Does it mean?
You give the main points, the most important parts. How do you decide what is the main point? What is the most important part?
Those parts.
Because when we watch all of it, we're gonna end of it. What we understand.
Does part impact me?
The part that impacts or touches you the most, the part that you understand the best. Okay. That same idea that you use when you tell someone about something that you watched, something that you don't like, something that's dirty, or something that's funny because you have a dog that does this, or a cat. You can bring the same kind of thought process to your writing, and that's what we're going to do with paraphrasing. I have a short video that I want to share with you, and this is posted on our Moodle page. It's down on the underneath the folder that says listening, reading, and vocabulary resources. So down at the bottom.
ELI 106R, paraphrase instruction and practice. To paraphrase means to restate or express someone else's idea using different words. Here is an example. Original text. Every day, people around the world send 50 billion text messages. Here is the paraphrase. People across the globe send nearly 50 billion texts each day. Original. Every day, people around the world send 50 billion text messages. Paraphrase. People across the globe send nearly 50 billion texts each day. Original text, speaking is the fundamental mode of human communication. Paraphrase, the most basic form of human communication is speaking. Notice the two things that changed. One, sentence structure. Two, vocabulary. Paraphrase process. One, read and understand the original sentence. Two, say what it means. Three, write what it means using synonyms and moving clauses. Try it. With the development of mobile technology, we can now call and text from almost anywhere on the planet.
Write down, just write, paraphrase. I'm going to paraphrase on the board while you're paraphrasing on your paper. Can you paraphrase this? Communication is possible from nearly anywhere on Earth thanks to mobile technology. Now, why did I use mobile technology? Maybe I could have said thanks to cell phones, that might have been better. Maybe I could say that, thanks to cell phones. Or I could maybe say thanks to smartphones. Maybe that would be better. So I used different words, but I also changed the order of ideas, didn't I? I talked about communicating anywhere. I pulled that up first, and then I said thanks to smartphones, thanks to cell phones. Communication is possible from nearly anywhere on Earth instead of the planet. The planet, of course, is Earth, thanks to cell phones, thanks to smartphones.
But I thought for another meaning, another thing.
You can't change the meaning.
Miss Alcott, you don't feel so far from anyone you can communicate with because of the development of the technology.
Nice. Yes.
From almost anywhere on the planet. Paraphrase. People can communicate from nearly any place on this planet due to the progress of mobile technology. Another paraphrase, humans can communicate from nearly any place on the planet thanks to advancements in mobile technology. Remember, use synonyms and change up the order of clauses and ideas as you paraphrase.